everyone. I am Cindy Lumpkin, the LD educator. And as you know, I am a special education teacher who happened to have started her own school. Today we are picking back up. I believe this is my second vlog. The first one, if you haven't checked that out, was about searching for properties. And I kind of went and just kind of laid eyes on about three or four different properties. Today, I'm actually going to be going and looking on the inside of one of those properties. And I wanted to take you guys along with me. If you didn't get an opportunity to, please go ahead on and check out the video I made about Karen McDonald, who is the prosecutor charging the parents of Ethan Crumbly, I believe is how to pronounce his name, the kid that shot up the school out in Michigan. I basically in that vlog or video was talking about how I feel like we owe her a debt of thanks, because she is really setting a precedent that parents need to take some responsibility for their children. And obviously she's not talking about just charging parents because you have some bad actors as children. You know, as a parent, we know that, you know, we can rear our children, tell them what's right or whatever, and they choose to do things differently. I think the key point is that this family was negligent. And as educators, I know we have all come across those parents. And so I think this decision is basically is going to be the turning point in education. So anyway, I am excited. We're almost there and I cannot wait to kind of go in. I have not seen this building, but I'm really excited about touring it. I know it has, this is the first one that I went to on the first vlog video, and it has a gym. So I'm not sure what else it has or what they would be allowing someone else to use. So we're gonna find all of that out. Okay guys, I am here. I'm really excited. Let's see, in gear. Miss Debbie started the tour off by showing me the gym, and it's a really, really nice gym. The property that we have been using has a gym that is not this nice. So, but it was a huge resource, and I'm so grateful that we had the opportunity to use it as a shared space, because the use of it was a huge part of our instructional program. So this is definitely a plus for this particular school. She showed me a couple of other rooms as well, things that I'm almost thinking maybe she was feeling like we could co-use. I'm not really interested in co-using instructional space. I definitely prefer to have our own space because I want my students to feel like they're at home. I don't want to have to set rules about touching certain things and so forth. It just probably will make for a better relationship if there are some spaces that are totally ours that we don't have to work with. Now, obviously, a space like the gym, we could use that together because I'm not going to be setting up shop and all of that. And obviously, for the most part, it wouldn't be used during the day anyway for them. We went ahead on and toured the space that I am thinking would be more ideal. She did show me a couple of sides of their building. I would prefer to be more in a centralized location so that my students will have the freedom to move around a little bit, but not be all over their facility. So it has a kitchen, a small kitchen, basically somewhere where if we did have some cooking classes, we could do it and they can warm up their food, but they do not have like a cafeteria. I generally like for my students to have a space outside of their classroom to actually eat. So that's going to be interesting. Now they do have a kitchen that has a stove and microwave, a nice sink and everything. So if we wanted to do some cooking classes, we could do it. The students could actually warm up their food. However, this particular kitchen does not also have a place to sit and eat. And I always like to have a separate location for my students to have lunch outside of their instructional place. The school where we currently are actually has a separate space where the student can eat. In addition, this property had kind of like two mirroring sides, so I'm going to be showing a different kitchen as well. But I think when I do my proposal, I'm definitely wanting to stay on one side, and we will see what I kind of ask for in lieu of a place for them not to be eating. So I may just ask for an extra classroom. They had several classrooms on that hall that you saw where we could definitely set up a place that's kind of like a gathering place outside of our classroom. All right, and it's always remains to be seen how much space we need depending on what the enrollment will look like for next year.
So it definitely has potential, and this side of town would be like some of my ideal candidates. So I'm really excited. I'm definitely going to make sure I follow back up, and which I basically have to give them a proposal. And what that would look like is basically telling more about my organization, really me pitching. So, you know, for those of you who will be eventually doing the same thing, you want to be able to tell your story. And you tell your story good enough to justify not paying probably the market price. Now, one of the things that she did tell me, their pastor is actually out sick, or he had COVID. He's getting better, thank God, out of the hospital and so forth, but he will not be back for the rest of the year. I think he's coming back the second week in January, she told me. So when he comes back, they're gonna have like a big meeting with their deacons, which runs their church. So all of the, I guess, major decisions go through this body and has to be approved by the pastor. So I will not know what their price point is. She just said that she really had no idea, you know, what to tell me. And so right now I'm gonna just put the ball in their court as far as kind of really honing in on why we don't need to pay as much as possible. And then we'll see what they come back with. And then, you know, if it's not something that I can afford, I would counter. And a lot of times, though, when you have a church who really understand what I do, who I do it for, how impactful it is, and they're in a position where they really want that extra income as well, it usually works. And I get to feel in that this church is like that. They actually had a school here for almost 20 years, and that school eventually moved out and found their own property. So, they know the benefit, and it could work. I hate that I have to sometimes beat, I don't want to say beat churches over the head, but some of them don't get it. But it makes no sense to have this big, nice building sitting in communities that really, really need help. And the only time the building is open is on a Sunday and maybe a Wednesday. So, anyway, I'm excited. I will make sure I come back with an update as soon as I hear any information. And prayerfully, I will get in to see the other buildings that we looked at last time as well. I'm still actually waiting to hear back to see if it is even a possibility. Because if you guys would remember, those buildings were not, or the churches themselves, I didn't have any real connection. So I knew somebody that knew someone that kind of directed me to this one. So the other ones are really going to be just like, I'm really cold putting things out there. So I definitely will still update you guys. All right, have a great one.